Sir, in year 1699, John Woodward, a British resident, invented the field hydroponics, where he used water combined with the nutrients of soil to grow crops, as represented here. So hydroponics is a way of growing crops without using the soil, so as to put the nutrients and required minerals in the water and provide them to the plants. There are three major ways to do it. Deep water technology, in which the plants are submerged in the water using a net system. The plant's roots are held in nets. The second one is wick system, where the water is taken up to the plant's soil roots by a wick, which absorbs the water from the bottom reservoir and takes it to the plant's roots. And the third one, which I have represented here, is the nutrient film technology, which takes the water from down here and takes it up to the plant's roots, continuously flowing, so as the plants can absorb the nutrients as required. So as I am filling up your water, I'll turn off the motor, and as you can see here, the water is being taken up to the upper reservoir where the plants are, and with time, that water, with the same water, is misted, is sprayed into the plant roots. It is known as aeroponics, and it was discovered in the year 1952 by G. R. Powell. Now coming on to the next part, that is integrated ChatGPT and AI for farmers. Before that, I would like to discuss some major differences between conventional agriculture, hydroponics, and aeroponics. So this is a standard aeroponic system. The basic differences which I am going to discuss are water efficiency, space efficiency, growth and yield. All of these which differ. Since water and space efficiency are much improved in aeroponics and hydroponics, because they use hydroponics has statistically proved that it uses 10% water, or the total amount which would be used to grow the same amount of crops in the field. And same for space efficiency, as they can vertically be combined so as to grow more crops in the same amount of area. One disadvantage which I would like to discuss is that hydroponics and aeroponics are not yet that much developed to grow commercial crops, or crops which are long, taller in height, because they can't support the crops from the roots. Now coming on to the next part, that is integrated ChatGPT and AI for farmers.
बेटा एक बात बताओ, ये अभी यूज हो रहा है कहीं भी पूरे वर्ल्ड?
यस मैम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैम, इन स्पेस नासा यूजेस हाइड्रोपोनिक्स टू ग्रो प्लांट्स इन द इंटरनेशनल स्पेस स्टेशन, बिकॉज सोयल इज नॉट फीजिबल देयर. एंड अदर देन दैट द वेल्दी फार्मर्स इन इंडिया आर ऑल्सो यूजिंग हाइड्रोपोनिक्स. ऑल्दो गवर्नमेंट इज प्रोवाइडिंग स्कीम्स फॉर इट, many farmers are not aware about this.
What ye madam hai Jaipur mein bhi use ho raha
hai, what will be the aage kitne saal tak
hai? soil nahi hai sir, hydroponics.
Hydroponics is quite developed for the time,
bahut sari building
hai. In the next year it could take a decade to several decades. That has not been
how much time take
For setting up the project, or
for development of this technology.
Then the development is already in the process, and as I would estimate, I believe it would take 4 to 5 decades for further improvement in the process.
मतलब ये future का वो है
ना? Commercialization.
Yes, sir. Commercialization will take place in the next few decades, and as I was saying that the commercial crops, such as mustard and wheat with taller heights, cannot be grown. That should also take place in the next few decades.
Are ye cheap technology, expensive?
So compared to the total resource loss and the time, time, energy, and equipment required in the field throughout the year, I believe it is cheap. Because for setting up a hydroponics and aeroponics system for small and medium size, the average amount of investment required once is 12,500 rupees. And then it can be maintained with time using the proper equipment and proper timing services. Next, I would like to come to my next topic, that is part 2, integrated ChatGPT and AI for farmers. So there are some pre-existing components and solutions for this problem, which are Farmer Chat and Kisan GPT, which provide the same kind of information to farmers. What are we hoping to do with it? So farmers have lack of knowledge, lack of equipment, and lack of places to go where they can acquire those proper resources, so as to conserve the environment and increase their yield with time. So how do we achieve that? ChatGPT and AI will be integrated and combined software or application, which will be provided to the farmers as per the government's rules. and it will inform the farmer regularly for the processes required in the field, hydroponics or aeroponics. And the farmer can also ask the subjective or objective questions which he can gain answers in his own local language.
So can you educate bhi to karna padega farmers ko?
Ma'am, that is very simple. Like nowadays, several farmers, like not very big part of the society, do not have a smartphone. Like search on the Google platform using the mic. The same way you can search in ChatGPT and AI combined.
सॉफ्टवेयर
है
मतलब उनको फार्मर्स को चलाना भी तो सिखाना
होगा
सिखाना पड़ेगा
फार्मर्स
बताना पड़ेगा
सो व्हेन दे विल ओपन द एप्लीकेशन डाउनलोड इट देन द एप्लीकेशन विल प्रोवाइड देम अ सीरीज ऑफ स्टेप्स ऑन हाउ टू ऑपरेट एंड इफ द फार्मर डज नॉट हैव अ स्मार्टफोन और अ स्मार्ट स्क्रीन ही विल गेट एन इंस्टॉल्ड स्क्रीन इन द हाउस वेयर द पर्सन हु इंस्टॉल्स इट विल टीच द फार्मर हाउ टू यूज इट. Now coming to the part, how AI can help farmers. The first solution is generating additional sources of income. Since the farmer will be educated about different fields of income and where he can invest so as to get more yield or earn more money, and that way he can generate more income for the time being. Next we will come to the next topic, that is providing additional educational resources. Nowadays farmers are not equipped enough to send their children to schools where they can be taught modern skills. So why can't we bring those modern skills to their homes? Using ChatGPT and AI, we are willing to do so. And along with that, the next part I would like to discuss is increasing yield with animal husbandry. Since farmers,
ये जो आपने इसे devices से
बनाए
हैं ना,
उनके
बारे में बताओ ना,
इसको
कब बताओगे?
ये कैसे अपने
सब के parts दिए ना? AI किसमें help कर सकता है उसके बाद?
बेटे उसके बाद क्या
आएगा
भी?
हाँ,
इसका आएगा
practice आगे.
Increasing yield for animal husbandry. Since farmers are only practicing agriculture these days, ChatGPT and AI will promote them to practice animal husbandry as well as horticulture because they can be additional sources of income for the farmer. Now the next is making government schemes available. Nowadays farmers are being scammed on a large scale on the name of the government schemes. Fake websites are being used to scam the farmers into taking their money. So ChatGPT and AI will provide them with the accurate information on where to go, how to find those schemes and how to avail the benefits. And the next one is improving the way of traditional farming. As I already mentioned, hydroponics and aeroponics, since the farmer will gain knowledge about these processes, the process of farming will be changed. The enriched resources, environment will be enriched with more resources than before. Since we were using excess of resources earlier and the environment could not cope up with the damage, using these type of technologies will help the environment cope up with the damage humans have done over the past years. Now I would like to come into the practical applications of AI. This map is a laser security system which works using an LDR. This is an LDR and this is a light laser. So as I plug in the Arduino, as you can see that this LDR is being displaced from the laser light, the buzzer will set off the alarm. But as soon as the laser will get inside and the LDR can take the LDR can access the light, this light will turn on and the buzzer will stop going on. Then we come to the next part.
What is the use of this setup?
Now this can be used in the security of the field as well as the house. As you know, the agricultural fields can be heavily damaged due to the intruders or the animals which come from outside of the boundary and damage the crop.
Now this application batao na thoda iske bhi application ye hai isme field mein ya agriculture mein ya household purpose ke liye
kisi use karte hain ye jaise aapne environment agriculture liya hua hai na to iska jo advantage hai uska agriculture mein zyada
usi mein explain karo integrate karo
usse hi correlate karna hai jitni bhi cheeze hai agriculture aur environment se hai na.
So this is an ultrasound sensor which will set off the alarm as soon as something comes in the range. For this I have set the range of 10 cm for in the Arduino coding, and as you can see in the range of 10 cm the alarm goes off. So this can be used on the corners or the vertices of the farm field where in just in case if an intruder comes, if the laser system is malfunctioning in any way, this will detect. Because this is a foolproof, because the laser can be distributed, it can be set to off, just by placing something. But as soon as the thing will, as soon as the object will go away in front of the sight, it will go off. So we know that when the object or the intruder is coming in front and when he is not. And based on this same technology, there is this RTO radar, ultrasound radar. As you plug in, it has a set range of 25 centimeters, where if anything comes in range in an angle of 180 degrees, it will inform the farmer. Like in this case, here.
Ye 180 degree rotate kar raha hai?
Yes, sir. And here we also have the angle.
Range ke liye 25 meters.
25 centimeters, sir, for now. And here the red dot will disturb. So the red dot is displaying where the
intruder is. It means one object.
So it will provide even more accurate data of the intruder. So if these two systems are malfunctioning, this will provide even more accurate data. And another system, another equipment which I would like to discuss is a soil moisture humidity sensor, also known as hydrometer. So in this component, I have used a soil moisture hydrometer and relay module to connect the hydrometer with the Arduino, an LCD screen of 16x2 and a 10k ohm potentiometer. So here, as I would connect it, we can see that the LCD turns on and starts with a random amount of moisture. As I take this plant, and since we can see that this plant is not very well moisture.
Mm-hmm.
So if we input it in here, so there is some, I believe there is some wiring problem.
Calculation is
the display is not
connection.
By using the AI and ChatGPT software, the farmer can determine what will be the required moisture for the plant, and we can place this in his field. So the moisture level will be checked by the LCD, and if the moisture level is below a set value, then the buzzer alarm will go off. Now there are two ways from here. Either the farmer can turn on the irrigation system on by himself, or we can attach an automatic water motor connected to the water reservoir here, and that would allow a specific time irrigation in the field, which would not increase the moisture above a fixed level. So that will help in the agricultural field by increasing the human efficiency, decreasing the time required, and saving the energy which can be further used in other fields for other sources of income and other advancements. So that was the part two. Now I will come to the part three, that is solar power. Now we come to the third part, that is solar power, the newer renewable energy. Why we are discussing solar power? Because it is one of the most advanced renewable technology and accounts for the third renewable energy source in the world after hydro water generation using dams, and after wind generation using windmills. So how do panels work? Why solar energy? First of all, we should know what is solar energy. Solar energy refers to the energy which is radiated by the sun in the form of light using small packets of light known as photons. And when those photons strike the metal placed on the solar panels, they generate photoelectrons, which in turn are captured by the distributor and in turn generate electricity in the DC form. So either we can use a battery to store the energy and then use an inverter to convert the DC to AC and use it in our homes for practical applications, or we can directly use an inverter to supply the energy.
When photoelectrons are ejected from the metal surface?
When the energy of the photon is higher than the work function of
slightly
the
higher than the
minimum amount of energy required is the work function. Mm-hmm. But on a practical application, it should be higher. Mm-hmm. Because just in case the electron is released, but it does not have any kinetic energy to travel from the anode to the from the cathode to the anode. And the maximum level at which it will go is the stopping potential or the cutoff potential, at which the photoelectrons will go no further. The current induced or the current
which
produced.
Which type of metals use?
Yes, sir.
which type of metals used to eject electrons?
Ma'am, metals which are low valency, low amount of valence electrons, such as sodium or magnesium and that's all.
Reactive metal. Cesium, like
rubidium, cesium. Ma'am, I meant the same. Like they have low amount of valence electrons, so they will release the valence electron with ease. Now, why solar energy? The energy sun radiates on the earth is assumed to be 173 quadrillion watts, around 10,000 times the current need of the planet. But why can't we utilize it? Because at this moment, the power of the efficiency of the solar panels is around 20% to 32.5%, which is the world record for the time being. And a threshold has been set as a target for 50% to be assumed, to be achieved by the time to be coming in the decades. So this is some these are some practical applications. For example, in this house, there is a rooftop solar panel. And this solar panel will not only generate electricity for the house, but it will also generate excess electricity which can be sent to the electricity grid, and the person can earn money rather than spending money on an electricity bill.
अच्छा सोलर एनर्जी में सबसे ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम किस में कैप्चरिंग में है स्टोरेज में है
सर नंबर वन इज कैप्चरिंग एज आई प्रीवियसली टोल्ड द एफिशिएंसी इज वेरी लो सो द फोटो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स व्हिच आर रिलीज मे बी हाई बट द एनर्जी व्हिच कैन बी कैप्चर्ड फ्रॉम देम इज क्वाइट लो एंड अनदर प्रॉब्लम इज इन ट्रांसमिशन बिकॉज एज द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज ट्रांसमिटेड फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर इट इज लॉस्ट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ हीट इन वायर्स एंड एज
एक अपने पास क्या कि स्टोरेज भी है जैसे कैप्चर तो हम कर लेंगे लेकिन स्टोरेज लंबे समय तक कैसा जब भी डिवाइस बन जाएगा तो बाद में तो कमी रहेगी ही नहीं मतलब स्टोरेज जैसे जितना हम कैप्चर करेंगे ना कैप्चर के लिए तो हमारे पास स्पेस बहुत है लेकिन स्टोरेज उतने को स्टोरेज करने के लिए हमारे पास में बैटरी है और
उसी में
और कोई ऐसा नहीं है कि उसमें जो सोलर एनर्जी तो स्टोरेज की मेन प्रॉब्लम है
वैसे बिजली बोर्ड है ना सर घरों में उन्होंने कह रखा है क्या सर आप बिजली बोर्ड को वो बिजली दे सकते
हैं चार्ज तो ये तो एक चार्ज बोर्ड हुआ ऐसे और कितने चार्ज बोर्ड हैं जो ये सेम एक्सिस्ट करते हैं और ये सेम वर्क करते हैं
फार्मर चैट एंड किसान जीपीटी दीज आर टू एप्लीकेशंस व्हिच आर एग्जिस्टिंग एट द टाइम
नहीं मैं जनरल इस कॉन्टेक्स्ट में नहीं मैं जनरली पूछ रहा हूँ
Okay, other than that, there is Microsoft Bing, Google Gemini, which are the two main popular.
And जो Chat GPT मतलब जो क्या कहते हैं चैट बॉट बनाए हैं उस कंपनी का क्या नाम है
OpenAI funded by Microsoft.
ये और कौन कौन से बॉट क्रिएट किए इन्होंने
As far as my knowledge, they have created four versions of Chat GPT. Starting with 1.0 and the latest is 4.2
and next is 4.5 also, which is an upgraded version.
Yes.
Other than ChatGPT, DALL-E and other softwares are also
they are working on it.
Yeah.
And now when we come to the talk of how solar energy became the beginning. So in 1900, Marianne Telkes, the now known as the Sun Queen, were born in the United Kingdom. And in 1939, she joined the MIT where she developed the solar still for the Pacific war stranded. So if the soldiers were stranded in the Pacific Ocean, they would be provided with the solar still, which could separate the salt from the ocean water and make it potable for drinking, so as they do not starve to death.
क्या बताया फिर से बताना solar energy को use कर रहे हैं potable?
No, I'm using the solar light. It is not using any kind of energy.
Solar light used to make ocean
to separate
water.
Soil from separate salt from water in the ocean water.
How it is possible?
I did not study
about
the schematics.
जैसे बेटा तू ये ले जाएगा इतना तो वो क्या है कि वो मतलब कंफ्यूज हो जाएंगे इतने में
सुनते सुनते कहाँ से क्या कोरिलेट
मेरा एक सजेशन है जैसे ये बहुत अच्छा बाकी सभी इसी से जोड़ दे
फोकल पॉइंट एक होना चाहिए अगर आपका एग्रीकल्चर है ना तो लेटेस्ट मतलब फ्यूचर क्या है उसका फ्यूचर एग्रीकल्चर का हमारा ये है क्योंकि लैंड हमारे धीरे धीरे कम हो रही है, तो हमें इस चीज पे आना है। तो इस चीज के साथ साथ हमें क्या असिस्टिव टेक्नोलॉजी यूज करनी है, वो सारी इसके असिस्टेंस में हो
सकती है।
स्ट्रेस इसके ऊपर रखना कि वो ये इसको हेल्प करने के लिए सब चीजें हैं।
सबसे पहले ही बता देना कि ये नाउडेज ये नहीं है, लेकिन ये आगे की टेक्नोलॉजी
होना करना पड़ेगा।
मतलब इसके लिए 40 साल भी ले सकता है या 22nd डेकेड की 21st डेकेड। हाँ चल रहा है, हाँ तो जितना भी देख लेना कि चल रहा है तो डाटा